But now, going back to the question, I'd say one of them would be Robin.
Oh, yeah.
Because when he burst onto the scene, he could score whenever he wanted. He was a joke.
Just remember him with his receding hairline, nice pair of F50s on. Yeah. That smells of that.
His first few goals was like he picked the ball up in the halfway line, didn't he? And just burst through one and just scored. And he looked like he could do that whenever he wanted.
Yeah, it kind of moved it like a little bit Sterling-esque, you know. It's not obviously not the wrists, yeah, but like that just quick change of direction, that little like almost untidy shuffle. But yeah, it was until I think it wasn't it Pulisic and then Tammy Abraham. But until this season, I think he was still Chelsea's youngest hat-trick goalscorer.
Who was he?
I am Robin.
Oh, was he?
And you forget like just how young he was as well when he was at Chelsea. That's a great shot, Lucas Leiva. I am Robin. All the purest choice, here, Glenn. Class. Is there anyone else you want to give a special mention to?
Did you think when Drogba came in, because obviously he came from the French league, sometimes we've seen players come over here and not adapt, and obviously, did you think Drogba would have the illustrious career he did? No. Was it evident from day one?
No, probably wouldn't have thought he'd be as good as he was.
No.
But that's not... Yeah. That's saying because how good he was, you know? Mm. So, but if you've got a perfect physique for the Premier League, then it's Drogba.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So, he was always going to find his feet eventually, and then, as you saw, start throwing defenders. Mm.
Philippe Senderos, yeah, see, he's ruined him. Never ever the same player against Drogba.
It's like Vidic and Torres.
Yeah.
What about, like, conversely, then on the flip side, players that join with massive reputations,
the worst
like Shevchenko? The question's setting Glenn up here. Now, but players like Crespo and Shevchenko that came as like world class players and just didn't have, and Veron as well, and just didn't have that same effect.
Yeah, it's odd. Well, even Torres. Yeah. I was with Torres at Liverpool and he was ridiculous, but then he went to Chelsea, similar like to the lads you just mentioned, for whatever reason, it didn't tick. But Pacheva was the mad one because the year before that, we played Milan in the pre-season, and the game was a decent game. But he came on, scored two, and won the game on his own. Mm. He was incredible, and obviously as a young kid, you know, we used to watch Shevchenko growing up, and think now he's coming to Chelsea, can't wait to see him training, and like literally in awe of him, and literally you couldn't believe it's the same fella. It was mad. It was mad. But I don't know if it's confidence or what, but... Yeah.
What, was he not even that good in training either?
No.
But it's just...
No, not for the level he's used to.
You saw
a few players like that. It's just, you know, like you mentioned Torres, like Kaká, who, like injury, they still got big money moves after their injuries that kind of robbed them of the player they once were. Mm. And, that was mad. Veron as well, like...
Yeah.
What a footballer.
But he was unbelievable. Like... He in training, he was unbelievable, like ridiculous. You could watch him all day.
Who did we have? I think it was Andy. Was it Andy Cole that said? Might have been Andy Cole that said Veron was just an unbelievable professional.
Yeah.
Like what? Is that the impression you got at Chelsea as well?
Well, I don't know about the professional bit, but
might be good.
But in terms of the performances, then he was. It's just literally beautiful to watch. You know, every touch was immaculate. And like I say, what was I, 18 at the time or 19?
Because he was like a Claudio signing, wasn't he? And then obviously when Jersey came in,
he wanted
players that would play for him, wouldn't it? Kind of thing. Like, so he kind of moved him on. We went on loan, didn't he? And then
that's right. Yeah.